Greetings, this is Peter Alexander. In this video, I'm going to show you a method of navigating the Character Creator to Blender pipeline using the Blender Auto Setup add-on. I've already created most of the clothing and props in Blender. I'm just going to export the clothed character, import him through the Blender Auto Setup add-on, adjust a few things, then send the various items back to Character Creator as props to be turned into accessories or skinned as clothing items. After I've exported the clothed character as an OBJ, I'm going to delete his accessories as I'll be importing them back individually. In Blender, I'm going to go to the CC3 tab provided by the Auto Setup add-on, and I'll be choosing the Import for Accessory option. This will split the various accessories into individual items for editing. I'm just adjusting the opacity map blend mode on the cigarette smoke I've previously created. It's not necessary for this stage, but it's good to know how to adjust this if you were to render this character in Blender. There's not a ton of adjustments I need to make for these particular items, but I did notice that the coat and pants could use a few additional edge loops. The clothing also had some clipping issues, although these could be adjusted directly within Character Creator. Since I'm here, I will adjust them. With the adjustments made, I'm going to export them back into Character Creator as static mesh accessories, meaning that they are currently unskinned. In Character Creator, I'm going to start importing the OBJ files as accessories. And since the clothed mesh was exported in this pose, they will mostly align to the character as he currently is. Items such as the cigarette, smoke, and probably the top hat and monocle, I will keep as unskinned accessories and simply parrot them to the appropriate bones. Whether your props re-import with some or all of the original textures depends on how things are set up in Blender. I'm not really an expert on these settings. I simply chose to reassign the textures where I needed to. One of the things that's good practice in Character Creator is to assign areas of the character's mesh to hide when an article of clothing is worn. This prevents things like skin poking through and gives the ability to delete these sections automatically during certain export options. After you've assigned your accessories as clothing, you'll want to try various poses to see areas that will need weight map adjusting. I noticed that the clavicle bone was pulling the suit's collar down too much, so I assigned some of the weight to the spine to lessen this effect. I also now notice that he doesn't have eyebrows, so I'll use the new hair system to give him some. I wanted the eyebrows to be a little thicker, so I lightly adjusted the opacity maps. Now I'm going to export this character for a final render in Blender's Eevee engine. I will choose to export to an FBX with this current pose, and I'm going to try to delete the hidden mesh, so hopefully I won't have to adjust any poke-through issues. In Blender, I will now import as a character with lighting and let the add-on assign the materials for optimal effect. The hidden mesh was deleted, leaving only minor poke-through issues. I'm just optimizing for a final render, and if there's anything you know about Eevee, there's probably little I can show you in this area. I hope this brief glimpse at the character creator to Blender pipeline has been of some use to you. I did not do much beyond take the items back and forth through the process, but hopefully you can see the potential for using Blender as an asset creation and optimization tool for character creator. And with that, I will conclude this video. My name is Peter Alexander. Thanks for watching.